The doomsday clock is an eerie symbol that represents the likelihood of a human-made global catastrophe. When the clock strikes midnight, it is said to represent a global catastrophe that would destroy life as we know it. When it was originally set, it stood at 7 minutes to midnight. It has been moved 27 times since that day, with it currently sitting at 90 seconds to midnight. Our civilization is a fragile enterprise with the threat of destruction looming around every corner. From climate change to nuclear war, there is always something ready to end it all. But as is our nature, us humans are very big-headed. What makes us so important and powerful that we are the only things capable to end life as we know it? Just 62 miles above our head is a silent, deadly vacuum that we call space. Our little home is located in the Milky Way galaxy, along with another 800 billion planets. But hurtling through our galaxy are millions of asteroids, all with the power to pull the plug on our little party in a heartbeat. I know what you are thinking. Yeah, but what are the chances that it actually happens? I mean, I've never seen an asteroid, let alone heard of one, hitting our planet, at least not since those pesky dinosaurs. Well, let me take you back to 1908, deep into the forests of Russia, where just that very thing happened. It was a normal summer morning in the Tunguska region of Russia, until local settlers noticed a light moving across the sky. This light, nearly as bright as the sun, suddenly flashed, producing a billowing cloud, followed by a pillar of fire that cast a red light on the landscape. The pillar split in two and faded into black, then there was nothing. For 10 minutes the locals stood confused and in awe of what they had just witnessed, when suddenly a huge boom was heard to the northeast, then a shockwave so powerful it knocked grown men to the ground and smashed windows hundreds of kilometers away. This mystery explosion was so strong, the blast was detected as far as Germany and even Washington, D.C. What could have caused this huge blast, the likes of which no one alive had ever felt before? Nearly 20 years passed until a scientific expedition took place, led by the geologist Leonid A. Kulik. Kulik observed a butterfly-shaped area of destruction measuring 830 square miles, with an estimated 80 million trees flattened. To put that size into perspective, London in the UK is only 607 square miles. Whatever hit Tunguska was a city destroyer. Much to Kulik's surprise, at the center of the explosion, he found trees standing firm with only broken branches and evidence of burning. Despite his best efforts, Kulik was never able to find any concrete evidence of what caused this mass destruction. Later expeditions to the area, however, found microparticles indicating an extraterrestrial origin. Most scientists today believe that what caused this immense show of destruction and power was an asteroid called Bolide. Bolide had a diameter of 130 feet and entered the Earth's atmosphere at a 30-degree angle, exploding 6 miles in the sky. If an asteroid of this size hit the Earth over any city or densely populated country, it would cause death on a scale never before seen by our species. It would wipe entire cities from the map and cause earthquakes and tsunamis that would be felt the whole world over. Tunguska was a truly terrifying event, and it is a reminder to our species that we do not live in a safe place. Around every corner there are a million more Tunguskas waiting to happen, and next time they may not strike over hundreds of miles of forests. I believe that we have a lot to learn from our past. History is a vital avenue to explore where our ancestors have gone wrong and what we can learn from their mistakes. One thing that nearly every ancient civilization was obsessed with was the stars. From the ancient Egyptians, Americans, and Indians, there are constant references to the sky, not just in writings from the times, but also in architecture, pointing our eyes to the skies. Perhaps this obsession with the stars was not just down to pure interest, but maybe it was done through fear. Fear of the danger that the stars can pose and of what can happen if we take our eyes from them for even a second. Thank you for watching. Please like and subscribe for more interesting tales from history.